Okay, we're going to combine these radical numbers. And to do so, we are going to first simplify all these radical numbers and see if they have the same radicals or not at the end, and then combine the coefficients. Okay? So first of all, look at square root of 45 and ask ourselves, what times what will give us 45? And one of the numbers has to be a perfect square. Can we do that? Yes, because 9 times 5 gives us 45, and 9 is a perfect square. So let's write this down as this. Let's break this down as square root of 9 times square root of 5. And let's work this out right here. This is the regular 6, and this is square root of 9, which is going to be just a regular 3. Regular 6 times regular 3 is 18, okay? And then we will put down the square root of 5. And once again, let me remind you guys, we will have to do the 6 times the 3. This is how we get the 18, and then you just maintain the square root of 5. So this is the first simplification for the first one. And then for the second one, square root of 20, what times will give us 20? And one of the numbers has to be a perfect square. Well, we know 4 and 5 will work, right? So square root of 4 times square root of 5. Now, let me bring down the minus here first. And this is a 3. And square root of 4 is a regular 2. And we multiply them together. 3 times 2 will give us 6. And then you maintain the radical number 5, like this. Lastly, square root of 80. What can we do? 4 times 20, sure, right? But better yet, we can use 16 and 5. Because 16 is the biggest square root number that will go into this and make this work, right? And in that case, you can actually just, you know, save one step. So let's break this down as square root of 16 times square root of 5. 16 times 5, we do get 80. And now, this is plus, this is 2, and multiplied by a regular 4. 2 times 4 is 8, okay? This is 8. And you can show work like this. You do 2 times, this is 4. So that's how we get 8. Maintain the square root of 5. And we see that everybody right here has a square root of 5. So we can combine these numbers together. So let's see. This is 18 minus 6 is 12. And then 12 plus 8 is 20, right? So we have 20. And because they all have square root of 5, you make it stay the same. Final answer, 20 square root of 5, and this right here is it.